Welcome to the video lecture. Due to corona effect, we are given to the recording videos. Okay, we need to complete the course outcome for topics in the CO4, especially we learn about the applications of synchronous motor, working principle, and starting methods, how power factor is corrected by using synchronous motor. We'll learn. So today's session we're discussing about the working principle of synchronous motor. After end of the session, we are able to understand how synchronous motor works. Okay. Three-phase synchronous motor. Where I am discussing the introduction about introduction about the synchronous motor and working principle starting methods circuit model and phasor diagram. You know already what are the parts of the synchronous machine. Synchronous machine having the two main parts, stator and rotor. Stator having the three-phase distributed winding, rod having the field winding. For example, it is a salient pole machine. So for understanding purpose, I am taking a basic model. The basic model having, you have the six slots, each two slots per each phase. Maybe R phase is started here after 180 degrees, the return path is getting. Now with respect to R, Y phase is started at 120 degrees, the return path is 180 degrees. Maybe the B phase is connected like. Okay. Once you give three phase AC supply, so maybe this is called as a stator. Stator having three phase distributed winding. This distributed winding, maybe it is connected either star and delta. This is connected to three phase balanced supply with some frequency. So once you give the supply, you develop the rotating magnetic field. You know the characteristics of rotating magnetic field. It rotates with the synchronous speed, that is equal to ns is equal to 120 f by p. Okay, this is the stator part, that is also called as maybe it has armature winding, that's why it is called as armature. Now another one is taken, this is the it is a two pole machine. For example, may be discovered here the having field winding. This field winding is exerted to some this supply, it draws some field current IF. So end of this winding, we apply the right hand thumb rule, it forms north pole to south. So how it is works? What the, you know that it is a synchronous machine. Suppose we are giving some excitation by battery, field is provided by, maybe holes are created in the, this rotor is coupled with the prime mover while it is rotating. So these conductor cuts the magnetic flux, EMF induces. So that's why the mechanical energy is converted to electrical energy. That is the general attraction. Suppose you are giving the three phase AC supply, maybe it draws the current. It draws the current. At the time, it develops the rotating magnetic field. Rotating magnetic field. For example, in our India, the frequency is equal to 50 Hz. It is a two pole machine. P is equal to here 2. So, at what speed the rotating stator poles are rotated? That equal to ns is equal to 120 into 50 by 2. That equal to maybe to the 3000 rpm. That means in 1 minute it is rotated 3000 revolution. For 1 second, how many revolutions are rotated? 3000 by 60, that equal to maybe 50 revolutions. So in 1 second, maybe the two pole machines, that way every part, every instance, maybe it is poles are rotated, the effect is rotated. Maybe for 1 revolution, take the time 1 by 50, that equal to 0.02 second. For 1 revolution, time taken for 1 revolution, 0.02 seconds. That means entire, for example, at a particular instant it is the north pole, it is the south pole. In 0.02 second, after 0.01 second, here it is south pole is came, the north pole is available. So that means one pole is moved, for a movement of one pole, how much time is taken? 0.01. Every 0.01 second, pole is changed. Pole position is changed here. Every 0.0 second, pole changes occur. So that means pole is rotated. For example, south pole is moving, after 0.01 second, this pole is coming here. So poles are rotated, affect the, actually it is a stationary part, but internal effect is changed. So that's why every 0.01 second, the poles are changed here. So at the, now, here the south pole is there, it is the north pole. What happened? Immediately these two are attracted each other, so strong alignment is occur. So that's why immediately try to move like that. But what happened? But due to moment of inertia, it try to move, but it is immediately after 0.01 second, immediately it comes north pole. So repel each other. Due to very fastness and inertia, try to move, repel. So, unable to run this machine. That means, synchronous motor is not self-started. But, how to bring self-start? How to bring the self-start mode? There are so many methods are there. Here, first of all, maybe one of the technology in our laboratory also we implemented that. By using a variable frequency source, we reduce very slow frequency, maybe very less frequency. At the time, maybe the frequency is very less, these revolutions are decreased for 1 minute. So 1 second also maybe 2 or 3 revolutions are getting. Time is also very available. So Now poles are slowly move. Once the in the starter position, at the particularly at the south pole is north pole is getting, or another here the south pole, here the north pole is available. Due to strong dissimilar poles are attract each other, that means the magnetic locking is occur. That's why we try to move. So in what speed the rotative magnetic field is rotated, the rotor is also rotated at the same speed. So slowly the magnetic locking, the machine is running. After that, we are increasing our frequency of the 50 hertz. The machine is, the rotating magnet speed is 3000 rpm. That's the rotor is also rotated to the 3000 rpm. This is the one of the method. So first one is the apply at starting. Apply reduced frequency. This is one method. The second method is provide external mechanical force, or other simply it is called the prime mover. Initially a small motor is connected, coupled to the starter. Due to that, maybe the DC motor, rotor is rotated, rotating magnetic field is rotated by giving the supply. So at a particular instant where the magnetic locking is occurred, automatically the machine is once it is synchronized the rotor poles and starter poles. So what speed the what speed is run by the poles, the same speed is getting in the machine. So that's why the machine is running at the synchronous speed. What the rotating magnetic speed, rotating magnetic field speed is maybe 3000 rpm. So it is simply, it is following the rotating magnetic field speed. So that's why it is also rotated with the 3000 rpm. That means once the starter poles and rotor poles are synchronized, or other magnetic lock, so the rotor is also rotated with the rotating magnetic field speed, that is called synchronous speed. So this is the another method. After once the lock it, simply remove the external force of the machine. Another the third starting method is called the damper winding. So damper winding, where it is provided? Generally the damper windings are provided outer surface of the poles. So actually here the slots are available. In that slots we are providing the copper bars or maybe aluminum bars. These are all bars are shorted by end plates in for all poles, maybe it is the 4 pole or 6 poles, whatever it may. Now how it is works? Simply, now once you give the supply, rotating magnetic field is developed. At the time, these are all conductors. The field is rotated, conductors are available. So that's why these conductors cause by that field, EMF is developed in all the copper bars. But it is a short circuit nature, so that's why all currents, all conductors carries some circulating current. So all conductors are now current carrying conductors. You know the basic principle. Any current carrying conductor placed at a magnetic field, it experiences the mechanical force. As like three phase squirrel cage induction motor. So squirrel cage induction motors also having the outer periphery, so many copper bars are there. All copper bars are shorted by the both sides, the end rings. So initially it is not rotated, but rotating magnetic field is moving. At that time all the conductor cuts the magnetic flux, so that's why all the conductors develop the voltages. So these voltages, when it is shorted, circulating currents are passing. So R current is passing in the winding. Current carrying conductor placed at a magnetic field experience the mechanical force. So now we try to rotate. But here the relative motion is the cause, so that's it is according to Glenn's is overcome that relative motion, it is also written the rotating magnetic field, where the rotating magnetic field is moving, the rotor also moving the same direction. So once you reach the synchronous speed, what happened? Once I reach the synchronous speed, what happened? So there is no relative motion, and there is no relative motion, there is no voltage. There is no voltage, there is no current. So that's why, that's all. But induction motor always is rotated with the below synchronous speed. But here what happened? Initially it is running with as like a induction motor, but once it is running induction motor, at the time we are excited very strong, excited these poles, maybe the field winding. Due to this field winding, it is act as a north pole, it is act as a south pole. At a particular instant, maybe once north pole, south pole is getting here the north pole is getting. So these two are attracted to each other. So once the magnetic locking occur in between the stator poles and rotor poles, the machine is rotated with the rotating magnetic field speed, that is called as a synchronous speed. So once it rotated, normally damper bars, normally in the steady state condition, in these damper conductors there is any voltage, it does not develop any voltage. But it is another advantage of this winding, that is the another bonus actually. What is that bonus? As a generator, for example, the machine is running with very heavy load, very heavy load. Suddenly one of the load is shut down. Once the load is shut down, immediately the heavy burden is reduced. That's why the machine will freely suddenly. So that's why it is rotated, try to rotate very high speed. So suppose it moves very high speed, maybe it lose the synchronous. The machine is dangerous. So that's why at that time, suppose it is move far away from the synchronous speed, relative motion is occur, and the relative motion is occur due to relative motion, voltage are developed in the conductors, but it is short circuited. When the short circuited current are developed, current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field, so torque is developed. So what is the torque that we actually exactly it opposes the that actual torque? So that's why it suppress the that suppress the oscillation. So once due to there are lot of suddenly the load variations, some jerkings, mechanical jerkings are getting, that is oscillating the machine. So there are two drawbacks: sudden change of load, mechanical vibrations is getting in the rotor. But this damper bar, suppose it is move away from the above synchronous or below synchronous speed, exactly it developed the opposing torques. So that's why it's reduced the as like providing damping torques. The damping torques suppress the oscillation. That phenomenon is also called as a hunting. Actually, that is called as hunting. So hunting, damper winding suppress the hunting. That is another advantage of the damper winding. So my conclusion here: synchronous motor is used for the constant speed applications. It is not self-started. That's why for self-starting mechanisms we are provided here, either by reducing the frequency, this is one of the method, or some external mechanical force. That means the rotor is initially coupled to the small induction motor, or maybe the DC motor, maybe some external force. It is running at the nearer to synchronous speed. After that, it is excited. Once the magnetic locking occurs, so this external force is not required, simply removed. But once it is synchronized, we don't require anyone. But it is rotated with the synchronous. Even the load is, we are providing, even the no load to full load, it always gives the same speed, synchronous speed. Maybe we have the only two speeds, either synchronous speed or zero. So that's why it is independent from the load. Even the load is changed, the speed is not changed. That's why it is called as a synchronous motor. But here the damper winding is provided for the starting purpose and improve the stability. How? This is the working principle of the synchronous motor. In the next class, I am explaining the circuit model and as a generator, as a motor, how to represent the phasor diagrams. And after that, I am explaining the effect of the magnetic field, effect of magnetic field and changing load. Explain. Thank you.